Hi guys, in today's quick how-to video, I'm gonna answer a question raised by one of my subscribers who asked how I deal with poor match performance. As I already mentioned in previous how-to videos, it's important to, from the start, as soon as you get up in the morning and you drive over to the range and you actually start the match, to adopt a positive mindset and a positive attitude. And yes, I repeat, as soon as you get up in the morning. Your initial objective should be to give it your best 100% performance for that particular match on that particular day. I recommend never to actually go and start off under 90%, 60, 70, 80, or even 90% as a starting point, because that will probably imply that you will be too slow and that will influence your hit factor. But I also recommend not to go over that 100%, because if you go over the 100%, you take too many risks, which will also lead to a negative impact on your hit factor, your overall points, and your time. So I do not recommend to go over the intended best 100% performance. The reality of IPSC and USPSA is that in all likelihood, you will probably, if you aim for the best 100%, you will probably end up somewhere between 90 or 95% of your best performance. And the preference obviously is around 95%. I would say that is the sweet spot. And why is that? Because during a match, something will happen. You will not plan for it, but that's how life works. It will just occur. You made a miscalculation in your stage planning. You're shooting a little slower than you intended to. You had a poor reload. You shot one or more Ds. You had to do a couple of pickup shots on some steel. Maybe you have one or more mics, no shoots. You slipped. You had a finger warning which distracted you, that was issued by the aero. Well, obviously we don't plan for these things and we try to avoid them as much as we can, but again, these things actually happen. And you have to realize that even if you give it your best 100%, in reality you will end up somewhere between 90 and 95% of your best performance. So shit actually will happen. It's important not to dwell on it. Don't focus on it. Don't go into it. Continue to keep that positive mindset that you started off with from the beginning. Also, very, very, very important is to continue to speak positive, even if these things happen to you on the previous stage. Continue to speak positive. Focus on the things that actually went well and don't focus on the things that went poorly. And even if you would discuss it, turn it around in something positive, indicating that those are things that you will work on during your next dry and live fire training. As already indicated also by other gun and IPSC, USPSA tubers on the web, I also concur that it's a poor habit to actually watch stage videos during the actual match itself, because it will distract you, it will take important time away that you need to prepare, check your gear, or to visualize the next stage. And also important, certainly before you are in the hole, it's important to socialize with your fellow shooters. So if you are watching these stage videos, it will distract from a lot of things. It will not really add anything of value to you. So I would also recommend not to do this. You can and you should, if you record your match and your stages, analyze everything at ease once you get home or the day after, to review what actually went well and what you identified to be improved on during your next dry and live fire training sessions. So again, the mental aspect of thinking positive and staying positive throughout the entire day, from getting up in the morning to going to bed at night, is very, very important. And you have to realize that shit happens, but if this happens, you can just flush it and move on.